Now we're going to talk about one of the more perplexing elements of rotations in 3D. I've got three coordinate frames here and they are all initially parallel to each other. The x-axis, the y-axis and z-axis are all aligned. I'm going to pick up the first one, the red one, and I'm going to rotate it by positive 90 degrees around its x-axis. Positive is in this direction, so after rotating it by 90 degrees in the x-axis, it looks like this. And now I'm going to rotate it by positive 90 degrees around the y-axis. Now the frame is going to end up looking like this. This is its final orientation. I'm just going to put it down there. Now I'm going to pick up the blue frame and I'm going to do the rotation but in the opposite order. So first of all I'm going to rotate it by positive 90 degrees around the y-axis. That's the positive direction, so it's initially going to look like this. And now I'm going to rotate it by positive 90 degrees around the x-axis. The x-axis is now pointing downwards. That's the positive rotation direction. So this is what the final orientation would look like. And we can see that these two frames have got very, very different orientations. So when it comes to doing rotations in three dimensions, the order in which you do them is critically important. Rotations are not commutative.
Cut. Let's look at the non-commutative nature of rotation matrix multiplication. I'm going to have a rotation of 90 degrees about the x-axis, and then I'm going to rotate by 90 degrees around the y-axis, and the resulting rotation matrix looks like this. If I do this in the opposite order, I rotate around the y-axis first, and then I rotate around the x-axis by 90 degrees in each case. I end up with a resulting rotation matrix which looks like this. And we can see that these two matrices are quite different. When you're multiplying rotation matrices, the order is critically important.